NFL news now. First came the snow, and now the meltdown.
Right, but we're still in for some active weather with windy and rainy conditions in our lower
elevations. We'll continue to see lots of snow in the mountains. I'm tracking the latest in your First Alert weekend weather forecast.
Plus, we're getting new information tonight in the investigation of an in-custody death at the Yakima County Jail.
This is Apple Valley News Now, special edition, On Your Side.
Well, we told you it was coming in your First Alert forecast. A significant amount of snow fell across our region overnight and into this morning, creating icy driving conditions on local roads. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Alyssa Warner. We're on early this evening so we can bring you the University of Washington Huskies Oregon Ducks game, that Pac-12 championship coming up at 5. But first, after this morning's snow, we're about to contend with windy and rainy conditions. We're going to get right to Stacey Lee, who is tracking all of that in your First Alert forecast.
So much tracking going on, Alyssa. Thank you so much. We continue to see rain on the west side, even some thunder and lightning bolts there. Active snow across the Cascades and the Blues. This pile of snow has been sitting right on top of Spokane all day long today. That's going to start moving out. Let's kind of get a little closer to where we're seeing closer to home snow towards La Grande. Most of it concentrated in the Blue Mountains and just barely on the edge of Dayton tonight. But things have kind of calmed down. Here's the storm track for tomorrow. That upper level system continues. We'll continue to see those snow conditions moving across and down the Cascades and into the Blue Mountains. But this is what we're watching next. It's called an atmospheric river. We've got a couple of those lining up. It's going to be bringing substantial rainfall to our region. We'll see those showers kicking in late tonight, early tomorrow for most of the day through the Columbia Basin, Yakima and Kittitas Valley. But again, the mountains will continue to see heavy snowfall, 1 to 3 feet, Cascade Mountains on top of that, 40 mile an hour wind gusts. We're looking at another 10 to 20 inches in the Blue Mountains, along with those strong gusty winds. We do have a wind advisory for the foothills of the Blues. We're looking at winds 25 to 35, gusting up to 50 miles an hour. So be prepared for that. We're also going to see those strong gusty winds in the Columbia Basin. Here's the Legends Casino Sky Cam. Look at all that snow out on Columbia Point this afternoon. 34 degrees. Our feels like temperature is 31. Our sunset at 4:12. So the rain starts tonight. Wind advisory that's going to be in place through Saturday afternoon, evening. Heavy snow continues across the Cascades and the Blues, and get ready, we have a bunch of rain headed our way all next week. I'll break it all down for you and my First Alert full weather forecast. Alyssa.
Thanks, Stacy. I-90 over Snoqualmie Pass is open this evening, but that was not the case earlier today. This is a picture of some of the congestion from just before 11 o'clock this morning. Hours before this picture was taken, WashDOT sent out an alert that eastbound I-90 had closed after they said approximately 30 semi-trucks that didn't chain up spun out. A second tweet later indicated that the road had reopened. And it's a good reminder about winter driving conditions. Many drivers think having proper snow tires or all-wheel drive on their vehicle makes it nearly impossible for them to spin out. The pickup trucks I saw this morning disproved that theory. So before heading out, check your tires to make sure they are properly inflated. Also, check your vehicle's battery to make sure that it's in good working order as well. And I shouldn't have to tell you this, don't use cruise control while you're driving on those snowy or icy roads. Make sure to give yourself and other vehicles plenty of space. Now, the speed limit for most highways may be 60 miles an hour or higher, but snow plows will be going about 35 to effectively treat the roads. And the Department of Transportation says if you're going to pass one of their plows, be sure you're doing it from the left lane. It's also important to have a good car emergency kit. Make sure that you always have items with you to help you stay warm, like hats, coats, and blankets. You'll also want to have a windshield scraper, a flashlight, first aid kit, booster cables, and a multi-tool like a Swiss Army knife. Cat litter or sand can also be helpful if you're stuck in an icy area and you need to get some traction under your tires. You can find everything that goes into a complete emergency kit over on our website, applevalleynewsnow.com. It's also important to remember the 4 P's during the winter. That means protecting your people, pets, plants, and pipes. For people, check on your friends, family, and neighbors and make sure everyone is okay. For pets, they need to have shelter from winter weather. You'll need to make sure that they have food and water available. And for plants, cover them up, especially if they are not winter friendly. For pipes, some of this that you're seeing here, insulate them if you can. Cover up outside hose spigots and make sure you know where your water shutoff valve is in case of an emergency. To get more in-depth information on preparing for our winter weather, just click on our winter weather article. Again, that's over on our website, applevalleynewsnow.com. We have more information of all of the stories and tips that you just heard. We have a follow-up tonight regarding the in-custody death at the Yakima County Jail. The Yakima Valley Special Investigations Unit is investigating, and Moxie Police provided new information. Investigators say Yakima County Jail staff went to move a man to another housing unit on November 24th. Now, police say he became combative and a physical struggle followed. Police say officers put the man into handcuffs. They then say he became unresponsive, and despite providing life-saving medical measures, he did die. Once the investigation is complete, this case will be forwarded to the Yakima County prosecutor. The first woman appointed to the U.S. Supreme Court has died. Former President Ronald Reagan appointed Sandra Day O'Connor to the High Court in 1981. She was a moderate conservative who upheld abortion rights and affirmative action. Her vote in the 2000 Bush versus Gore election case ensured that George W. Bush won the presidency. In 2018, she announced that she was battling dementia. According to the Supreme Court, Sandra Day O'Connor died from complications of that disease. She was 93. Three local municipalities will receive big grants from the state. According to Benton County's Facebook page, Benton City will receive $100,000 to repair tennis courts in Archie Borden Park. They've been closed since 2021. The county says the Port of Kennewick will receive more than $82,000 to repair amenities on Clover Island. And the city of Prosser gets a $100,000 grant to buy a lawnmower to maintain 27 acres of parkland. All of those grants come courtesy of the Washington State Recreation and Conservation Office. The 14th annual Bikes for Tykes bike build took place this morning. More than 600 volunteers met at the Three Rivers Convention Center in Kennewick to put together more than 1,600 bicycles. Apple Valley News Now is partners with the UA Local 598 for the Bikes for Tykes event. And we had some of our staff building bikes this morning, taking part in all of the fun. Now, all these bikes were built today by hundreds of volunteers. This is a time lapse showing the progress of that work over the course of the morning, just how many people were there as well, making sure that these bikes got built. If you didn't make it down to the Three Rivers Convention Center, Apple Valley News Now's Riley Fitzgerald takes us inside the Bikes for Tykes build day.
It's exploded. You know, we've grown so fast, so quick, it's hard for us to keep up. We're thinking there'll be about 600 volunteers. Today we'll build about 1,600 bikes, and Griggs and Pasco, Charlie and Dennis work with us throughout the year to make sure we get all these bikes in place. In 2023, in our 14 years, we'll hit 20,000 bikes and helmets we've donated throughout the community. And the only reason we can do that is because of the generosity of the community and organizations. We send these bikes all over, right? From little kid bikes that go into the schools. United Way does the Attendance Matters program. And so they take mountain bikes into the schools. And they, at the end of the year, they do a drawing for kids that have had great attendance. And it really helps boost the attendance in schools, which boosts the kids' grades and their education. They go to veterans organizations, police, firefighters. We donate several of them to our other local building trades unions, and they give them out through the community. And so we really focus on trying to get them to the people who need them. You know, we're not perfect by any means, but we do our best.
Now, the goal here is for every child to know the joy and independence of riding their own bicycle. Event coordinators tell us Bikes for Tykes costs around $200,000 to put on every single year. And as we said at the top of the newscast, we are on early to bring you the Pac-12 title game, UW versus Oregon. Both will play for a spot in the college football playoff, but Oregon is favored by 10 points coming into this game. Now, the matchup also features two of the favorites for the Heisman Trophy, Oregon quarterback Bo Nix and UW quarterback Michael Penix Jr. The Huskies will need to beat Oregon for a second time this season if they want a chance to play for a national championship.
This is what we work for, you know, since January 3rd when we had our first team meeting. You know, guys deciding to come back. It was to win a championship, you know, and you don't talk a lot about it once you get into the season. And now we get to, you know, focus on the next game, and that next game is the championship game that that we've had our sights set on since day one.
All right, you can catch that game right here coming up at 5 right after our newscast. And we are learning more about the possible future of the Pac-12, just two schools planning to remain in the conference. Now, according to Yahoo Sports, Washington State University and Oregon State University are now close to an agreement with the Mountain West Conference. Yahoo Sports reports the schools would not be part of the conference, but would play conference teams. They say they're expecting an announcement will be made soon. Well, catching the festive spirit, we're going to talk about all of the events taking place locally that'll put you in the holiday mood. That includes the Sela Lighted Parade taking place tonight. That's one of our previews coming up next. We are in for a wet and windy weekend. Stacy Lee is tracking all the latest developments in her First Alert forecast next on Apple Valley News Now.
Black Friday mattress discounts have been extended today through this Monday at Walker's.
Save up to $900 on Serta iComfort and Beautyrest Black Hybrid sets. Plus, save up to $300 on Purple mattresses and take advantage of no money down, no minimum purchase, no interest for 5 years.
Plus, receive up to $300 of free furniture, making it the perfect time to improve your sleep for less.
This Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday at Walker's.
Stay tuned to get this knife set free from Granite Stone. Does cooking with your old pans feel like a kitchen battle? Scratches here, stuck on food there, and burnt on debris everywhere. You need to bring in battle-tested pans with armor. You need Granite Stone Armor Max, the revolutionary cookware set with four durable layers of ultra non-stick. So slick, virtually nothing sticks. No oil or butter needed. Granite Stone Armor Max is the fast, easy way to make your family five-star gourmet meals that slide right out. Forged from durable aluminum with a hard anodized exterior, then coated with 1, 2, 3, 4 Armor Max layers to create our most durable ultra non-stick granite stone pans ever. In fact, they're 800% longer lasting. They're oven rated up to 500 degrees and come with tempered glass, easy pour and strain lids. Plus, all Granite Stone cookware is 100% metal utensil and dishwasher safe. Look, you'd expect to pay up to $500 for a professional quality cookware set, and you still wouldn't get four layers. But during this special TV introduction, you can get the Granite Stone Armor Max set not for $500, $400, or even $300, but for just five easy payments of $39.99. And for everyone who orders today, we're going to drop one payment. You get it all for just four easy payments of $39.99. Plus, we'll include this razor-sharp six-piece knife set free. But this deal keeps getting stronger. You'll get our Armor Max Deep Steam and Fry Pan set, yours absolutely free. That's an incredible 20-piece Granite Stone Armor Max set, all for just four easy payments of $39.99. Plus, we'll ship your entire order free. Order now.
To order, call 1-800-560-0523 or order online at buyarmormax.com. So call 1-800-560-0523 or go to buyarmormax.com.
Portions of Apple Valley News Now, sponsored by Lord's Health and Trios Health, making communities healthier.
Welcome back. The weather has been a little bit frightening today in Yakima and the Tri-Cities. Apple Valley News Now's Emily Goodell has a peek at what that snowfall looks like in Sela.
The snow's been coming down pretty hard over here, and as you can see, it pretty much covered everything overnight. But what it's not doing is stopping the holiday cheer. Tonight is the annual lighted parade in Sela, when hundreds of residents head outdoors to see the dozens of lighted trucks, floats, and vehicles on display. Because of the parade, roads will be closed from First Street Jim Clements to Goodlander from 5:30 to 7. The parade starts at 6, and if you feel like braving the weather to go see it, make sure you bundle up. Reporting in Sela, Emily Goodell, Apple Valley News Now.
Thanks, Emily. Now, Yakima's 23rd annual holiday lighted parade is coming up on Sunday. That parade kicks off at 6 p.m. It'll be headed down Yakima Avenue, starting at 6th Avenue and ending at 3rd Street. When the last float is done, the City and Downtown Association of Yakima will have a lighting ceremony for the community tree at Millennium Plaza, where they'll also announce the winners of the parade.
The best part is watching the kids' faces light up when they see all the floats coming down Yakima Avenue. That's been my favorite part, to try to get photos of families. They get so happy, you know, and it feels like they're bringing a sense of happiness to downtown.
The parade is organized by the Yakima Sunfair Parade Association. This year, they're expecting about 50 participants and around 4,000 spectators. Historic downtown Prosser will be holding its tree lighting this evening. The fun starts just about 15 minutes from now. I got to check out the preparations earlier today. Now, local businesses have been setting up displays around the parking lot of the historic depot. And starting at 5 o'clock, you can come check out all of the magic for yourself.
We're going to have free hot cocoa for everybody. We're giving away toys for the kids. We're going to have Santa brought in on a fire truck. I mean, it's so much fun. This is going to be Prosser's Hallmark moment. We are so excited.
I can confirm there is lots to see. You can even vote on which displays you like the best. That is coming up from 5 until 7 this evening in Prosser. And that Santa is a busy guy. You just heard he's going to be rolling into Prosser on a fire truck this evening. He'll be here in Kennewick tomorrow morning. The hometown holiday parade starts at 10 o'clock Saturday morning along West Kennewick Avenue. And the historic Downtown Kennewick Partnership has been working on this parade for months. Now it's all about to pay off.
We've been very diligent negotiating with Mrs. Claus and the elves to make sure Santa would be available for our holiday parade. We also have Santa Square opening at 9 a.m. an hour before the parade starts, where you can get hot chocolate, something to eat for breakfast. We'll have letter to Santa activity. And then after the parade, you can get your picture with Santa and meet some of the miniature horses that are in the parade.
All right, you could show up early if you want to in order to get a good parking spot. If you still have some Christmas shopping left to do as well, maybe check out some of the downtown businesses. They are still offering special perks and opportunities to win prizes for a couple more weeks. The Yakima County Sheriff's Office will be at Walmart stores in Yakima and Sunnyside this weekend for the Jasmine Strong Holiday Toy Drive. This started 5 years ago when Jasmine, who's a 15-year-old girl with bone cancer, decided to give back and help kids going through similar struggles. Since then, the effort has grown from 4 stores to 18 across Oregon and Washington. That includes the ones in Yakima, Sunnyside, College Place, Kennewick, Richland, Pasco, Pendleton, and Hermiston.
Children who can't remain at home during Christmas time and have to be in hospitals deserve and should have presents and toys to open while they're away from their families and they're away from their family home.
The Jasmine Strong Toy Drive will be going on Saturday and Sunday from 8 to 6. The toys will then be sorted and distributed to hospitals across the region in the coming weeks.
From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Stacy Lee.
And there's a lot going on in the weather. We've been tracking that snow. It's falling all the way from Ritzville into Spokane tonight and in the Blue Mountains here from Dayton all the way down into Oregon. We are seeing a little bit of snow across that I-84 area into the LeGrand section. Cabbage Hill, though, I checked a little while ago, is looking pretty good tonight. 34 degrees on our Legends Casino Skycam. Our feels like temp at 31, and our sun has already set. But you see all that beautiful snow out at Columbia Point Golf Course. We do have a winter storm warning. Those are going to stay in place through Sunday. We're continuing to see snow in Spokane. That'll start to dry out overnight tonight. Heavy snow across the Cascades, plus strong gusty winds, and we'll continue to see heavy snow in the Blue Mountains as well. 10 to 20 inches winds, again, up to 40 miles an hour at times. Here's the storm track for tomorrow. It's moving right across our area. Then we've got the setup coming in known as an atmospheric river. Look at all of that moisture on the west side. They're setting up for potential flooding over the next couple of days. We're going to see our snow transition to rain showers as we're going to have warmer winds coming in. Storm track on Sunday, all that moisture I was talking about continues to head to the east through our area, off into Spokane, and we'll still see some snow here and there in the mountains. However, most of the lower elevations will be seeing pretty substantial rain. Once it starts raining, it's not going to stop for several days. Here's our future cast, and here's our rain showers coming through this area tonight. We'll continue to see those snow showers across the Cascades. Getting into your Saturday morning, heavy rain showers towards the Yakima Valley, moving its way into the Columbia Basin, Tri-Cities, more snow for the Blue Mountains, and that track continues. Here comes Saturday, more snow Saturday night in the Cascades as well as the Blues, with more showers coming our direction. And again, look at this. So then our snow in the mountains transitions to heavy rain. So all the snow that is falling is now going to melt, which could cause some substantial flooding on the west side of the state. We're going to be keeping a close watch on that for the next couple of days. We'll see little rounds of clearing, but gusty winds also in the region. Let's talk about how much rain we're going to see accumulating here in the next 24 to 48 hours. Near Walla Walla, you could see close to an inch, as well as Pendleton, a little over half an inch in Yakima, a little bit less in Ellensburg, and much lighter in the Columbia Basin, but we'll keep an eye on those totals. We do have a wind advisory in place for the foothills of the Blues, Pendleton, Walla Walla, Dayton, till 6 o'clock on Saturday. We're going to see strong gusty winds even in the Columbia Basin, gusting up to 50 miles an hour. Let's take a look at our future cast winds. You'll start noticing them picking up overnight tonight in the Columbia Basin Tri-Cities. We're going to have bouts of gusts gusts up to 50 miles an hour here and along the foothills of the Blues. So very strong winds headed our way, and that will continue through Saturday night. We'll calm down Saturday night, then those winds are going to pick right back up on Sunday as those systems move through the area. Pendleton, Tri-Cities, foothills of the Blues, all the way down the Columbia River Gorge. So very, very windy. We need to worry about that. Our temperatures tonight are on the warming side, believe it or not. Even though it's showing 29, we're going to see those temperatures coming up above the freezing level as the evening progresses. Look at our daytime highs tomorrow. We're hitting the 50s. We've been in the 20s and 30s all week, so that's a 25 to 30 degree difference from where we were just a few couple of days ago. Let's talk about tomorrow. Here is the temperature outlook. Those showers in the morning, kind of cloudy and overcast, but check out those winds. They're going to be around pretty much all day. Same thing in Yakima. Look at those temperatures. 32 to start with, but warming up into the mid 40s with those breezy and gusty winds through part of the day. Walla Walla is going to see those strong gusty winds most of the day as well, with showers for most of the afternoon. And Hermiston will start out with rain. It'll start to decrease throughout the day, but those strong gusty winds also coming through the area. So a lot of active weather going on. My advice is if you're having to travel over the passes or towards Spokane or even towards the Portland area, check those pass reports and be prepared for adverse driving conditions. I've got more. Your 7-day planning forecast is on the way. Stick around. We'll be right back with more.
Portions of Apple Valley News Now, sponsored by Lord's Health and Trios Health, making communities healthier.
TCU is awarding you a $1,000 donation.
Everybody volunteers.
It costs us over $100,000 to put on camp every year. Seeing these kids smile is pretty terrific.
Please tell us a story of someone you believe is making an impact.
The secret of every great chef is their knives and how well they sharpen them. Imagine a knife taking this much abuse and didn't need sharpening. Imagine no more. Introducing the incredible NutriBlade knives from Granite Stone. Coated with Granite Stone nonstick and made of stainless steel, one of the hardest substances on earth, for ultimate cutting-edge durability. Now everyone can chop, slice, and dice just like a pro.
Very comfortable.
Wow.
Very sharp.
I thought you had to be a professional chef to cut like this.
This is really an incredible knife.
The Easy Grip rubberized handles deliver incredible control and accuracy to chop salads in seconds, cut frozen solid meat with ease, and get razor-thin slices every time. The non-stick surface means food slides right off, and they're dishwasher safe. Plus, they'll stay razor sharp, guaranteed. Why pay hundreds? Today, you'll get this complete set of six NutriBlades for only $29.95. You'll get the powerful Santoku knife to chop large fruit and dice onions, the slicer for razor-thin veggies and deli meat, the serrated bread knife for slicing fresh, warm bread with ease, the ultralight chef knife with reduced surface area for less friction. This versatile utility blade is great in the kitchen and around your home. And the precision paring knife for peeling and garnishing. $29.95 is an amazing value, but order right now and we'll even ship them to you for free. So get your own NutriBlade knives from Granite Stone, the last knives you'll ever buy.
To order, call 1-800-524-6914 or go online to buynutriblade.com. That's 1-800-524-6914 or go to buynutriblade.com. Order now.
Tis the season as we visit a Christmas tree farm.
It's a pleasure to work here. I enjoy the customers a lot.
Find your holiday spirit.
It's a fun time.
Fly the Northwest. Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
What do you got on your list?
MeTV is making a list, and you can check it twice. Go to MeTV.com for the full list of our very merry MeTV holiday programming.
Broadcast channels 35.2 and 42.2 and on Spectrum Channel 182.
Welcome back. The Sunnyside Police Department says its Thanksgiving meal giveaway was such a big success, it wants to do it again for Christmas. The department posted this graphic and information on its Facebook page. Sunnyside Police say that this time they're planning a ham giveaway, but the effort needs community partners to make it a success. So if you can volunteer or donate, you can contact the Sunnyside Police Department. The number to do that is 509-837-2120. More information on that giveaway to come. And skiers and snowboarders, the Tri-Cities Ski Swap takes place this weekend. That's tomorrow from 10 to 5 at the Benton County Fairgrounds. The event is put on and organized by Dusty's Ski in Tri-Cities. We'll have a final look at your First Alert forecast next.
Portions of Apple Valley News Now, sponsored by Lord's Health and Trios Health, making communities healthier.
Not being able to see up close can be frustrating. Trying to view your mail, enjoy your favorite book, or even read a prescription bottle can be impossible. Introducing Eye Candy, the sweet new way to see everything bigger, brighter, and better than ever before. And now may be your last chance to get one before they're gone. Fun in design, Eye Candy is no toy. This lightweight, easy-to-hold magnifier utilizes an optical-grade lens that enlarges print by 300%. Yes, 300%.
Eye Candy is really a step above the rest. The magnification is fantastic.
Embedded in Eye Candy's frame are 12 anti-glare LED lights that dramatically help increase clarity. It's a flashlight and magnifier in one.
Even with my reading glasses, I'd still have a problem with the small print. With Eye Candy, everything is bright and clear.
Lightweight and portable, Eye Candy is ideal for extended periods of reading or when you're on the go.
I use Eye Candy when I go out to dinner. Reading the menu, so much easier, especially in the dim light.
Zooming in on your electronic devices only lets you see a small portion of your message or pictures. With Eye Candy, you can see it all.
I showed it to my husband and it strangely disappeared. I purchased two more. We keep one in the kitchen, one in the garage, and one in the car.
Read recipes, prescription bottles, or nutritional information, and never miss the fine print. Order now to get your Eye Candy for only $19.99. But wait, there's breaking news. Eye Candy may be discontinued. Due to rising costs and supply chain shortages, Eye Candy is shutting down and stopping manufacturing effective immediately. There's a strict limit of 3 Eye Candies per order while supplies last. You still have time to get your very own Eye Candy, but you must act fast. Once the current inventory is gone, it's gone forever. Order now.
Call 1-800-941-3546. That's 1-800-941-3546. Or visit tryeyecandy.com. So call 1-800-941-3546 now.
Does this look familiar? You probably think this is what owning hearing aids would be like. Let me tell you, there's a better way. The Atom by Audion Hearing. The all-new Audion Atom is the world's first wireless charging hearing aid under $100. The Atom comes with an easy-to-use wireless charging dock. Plus, the Atom has a 22% smaller design, so it's nearly invisible when worn in the ear. That's why we have over 250,000 happy customers. Each pair has a 45-day money-back guarantee, so there is zero risk in trying them.
Call 1-800-357-9156. That's 1-800-357-9156. Call 1-800-357-9156 or go to audionhearing.com to get your pair of Audion Atom hearing aids for only $99.
So we had our taste of snow this morning. Get ready for a lot of rain. Look at that, Alyssa. That is rain after rain after rain. This is a setup. We've got a couple of atmospheric rivers pointed right at our direction. And so that's going to create lots of rain showers here over the next several days. The good news is our temperatures are warming up. Look at that. We'll see 50s. We haven't seen that for a little bit. And those overnight lows will stay above freezing for most of the week next week. Let's take a look at Walla Walla and Hermiston. It's going to be wet there as well. No breaks. So get the umbrellas out, the rain boots, and I don't know, rain gear.
Yeah, I think Jason was saying this morning our state is going to be in soup.
In soup. We're a bowl of soup now.
It is soup season, you know. I'm okay with it.
Perfect.
Thanks, Stacey. And thank you so much for watching. Next is the Pac-12 Championship. University of Washington Huskies facing the Oregon Ducks in Las Vegas. And we're back after the game. In the meantime, you can find the latest anytime on our website, applevalleynewsnow.com.